Hello everyone, welcome to Lectures by Aparna. This is a part 1 video of GATE 2020 Electronics and Communication question paper discussion. So let's start with the question from Analog Electronics. So this is a question from OPAMP section. So I'll read the question. In the circuit given below, all the components are ideal. Given VI is 2 volt, find I0 in milliampere. So this is the circuit and it is said that the op-amp is ideal. So there is a condition for op-amp to be ideal. Two conditions, that is the voltage at the non-inverting terminal is equal to the voltage at the inverting terminal, and the current that is flowing into the op-amp, that current will be 0 amperes. So here I am considering current through 1 kilo ohm, let it be I1, let this current be I2, let this current be I3, let this voltage will be the same as that in the non-inverting terminal. So here it will be VI, let this be node 1 and let this be node 2, and the current flowing into this, that is 0 ampere. 0 ampere will be flowing into this. Now I have to apply KCL, Kirchhoff's current law, KCL at node 1. So this is node 1. So applying KCL at node 1, the current that is flowing into this node will be equal to the current flowing out of this. That is I1 is equal to I3 plus 0 ampere. So I1 can be written as, let this voltage here be V0. So I1 will be V0 minus VI, V0 minus VI by this 1 kilo ohm, that will be equal to I3. I3 is this VI minus the voltage here is 0 divided by 1K. So this will become V0 minus VI is equal to VI, or you get V0 is equal to 2VI. You get this condition. Now I have to apply KCL at node 2. So applying KCL at node 2, I can write the equation as I0, that is current flowing into this node, will be equal to the current flowing away from the node, that is I1 plus I2. I0 is equal to I1 is V0 minus VI by 1K plus I2 is V0 by 1K. V0 is written as 2VI. So 2VI minus VI by 1K plus 2VI by 1K. This will be 3VI by 1K. VI is given as 2 volt. So substituting that here, I will get I0 is equal to 3VI by 1K, which will be equal to 3 into 2 by 1K, that will be 6 milliampere. So the answer here is I0 equal to 6 milliampere. Now let's see next question. Next question is from Digital Electronics. So this is a 4x1 multiplex. I will read the question. For the given 4x1 multiplexer, find the expression for output F, given that EN is enabled pin. So here these P and Q are the select lines, and enable pin is an active low pin. So if a 0 come here, this mux will be enabled. So here already a 0 is coming, so this mux is already enabled. Now depending on the value of P and Q, any one of the input will come at the output. So when PQ is 0, 0, I0 will come at the output, that is this R will come at the output. When it is 0, 1, this 0 will come. When it is 1, 0, this R will come, and when it is 1, 1, this 1 will come at the output. So I can write the truth table as P, Q and F. Four conditions are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So what will be F? When it is 0, PQ is 0, 0, I0 will come at F. I0 is R. Now when it is 0, 1, this 0 will come at the output. When it is 1, 0, this R will come at F. And when it is 1, 1, this 1 will appear at F. Now I can write this expression as F is equal to P bar Q bar R plus P bar Q into 0 plus P Q bar R plus P Q into 1. So this will become P bar Q bar R plus this term will become 0 P Q bar R plus PQ. Now from this Q bar R can be taken as common. So Q bar R into P bar plus P plus PQ, or this will become Q bar R. This is 1. So Q bar R plus PQ. Answer is PQ plus Q bar R. So this is the answer for this question. The value of F is PQ plus Q bar R. Now let's see next question. Next question is from the section of 8085 microprocessor. So I'll read the question. In 8085 microprocessor, number of address lines required to access 16 kilobyte memory bank is. So here the size of the memory that is to be accessed is given as 16 kilobytes. So this is the memory. This can be written as 16 into 1000 into, this can be 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. So into 8 bits. This memory, total memory will be equal to 2 raised to n into m. This m is the number of data lines and n is the number of address lines. So here 8085 microprocessor is an 8 bit microprocessor. So this m will be 8 because there are 8 data lines and we have to find the number of address lines. So 2 raised to n into 8 is equal to 16 into 1000 into 8. This 8 and 8 will cancel. That is 2 raised to n is equal to 16,000. So the value of n is approximately equal to 14. Therefore there are 14 address lines. So the answer is 14. Now let's see next question. The next question is from the section control system. So I'll read the question. In the figure given, C of S is equal to K into S plus 1 by S plus 3 and G of S is equal to 1 by S into S plus 1. If the steady state error for a unit RAM input is 0.1, then find the value of K. So here from this I can write the open loop transfer function as C of S into G of S, that will be equal to K S plus 1 by S plus 3 into S into S plus 1. So this will be the open loop transfer function. Now for a unit ramp input, the velocity error constant KV is given as limit S tends to 0 S into C. Here the open loop transfer function is C of S into G of S, which will be equal to limit S tends to 0 S into, substitute this value, that is K into S plus 1 divided by S plus 3 into S plus 1. So this S will cancel. This will become, applying limit, the value will be K into 1 by 3 into 1. That will be K by 3. Now the steady state error is given as 0.1. Steady state error is given in the question as 0.1. So the relation between steady state error and velocity error constant is ESS is equal to 1 by KV. Now I got KV equal to K by 3. This will be 1 by K by 3. So this will be equal to 0.1, or K is equal to 3 by 0.1, which will be equal to 30. So the value of K is 30. So we will continue the part 2 portion very soon. If this video has helped you, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.